Let's get it started. For today class, we have to start about a topic that's called locomotion in earthworm. Achha, if I am asking about a part locomotion in earthworm, earthworm belongs to which class of earthworm? Earthworm कौन से phylum से belong करता है? बासित अपना mic बंद कर दो. एग्जैक्टली राइट फाइल है. मैंने लेटा, चलो अभी भी आ चुका है, ज्वाइन कर लिया इसने हमें. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट इट अबाउट अ पार्ट दैट्स कॉल्ड लोकोमोशन एंड अर्थवॉर्म. सारे बॉयज हमें ज्वाइन कर लिए है और अर्थवॉर्म बिलोंग्स टू फाइलम दैट्स कॉल्ड एनेलिडा. लास्ट बता सकते हो व्हाट वुड बी द क्लास ऑफ अर्थवॉर्म? आइदर इट वुड बी ओलिगोचेटा, पॉलीचेटा, हाइरोडिनिया. कौन सी क्लास थी अर्थवॉर्म की? ओलिगोचेटा. एंड व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय द वर्ड ओलिगो? अभी अगर मैं ओलिगोचेटा के हवाले से पूछता हूँ तो ओलिगो का मतलब क्या होता है? ओलिगो मीन्स फ्यू. एंड यस, व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय द वर्ड चेटा? सीटे. यस सीटे. ओके चेटा डेट फ्रॉम वर्ड सीटे. एंड व्हाट इज दिस, व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ सीटे? आइदर इट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर रिस्पायरेशन, रिप्रोडक्शन, लोकोमोशन और डाइजेशन. यस एग्जैक्टली राइट. Exactly right. That is setae, cheta, that is responsible for locomotion. ठीक है. तो if I am talking about for earthworm, regarding about the part for earthworm, the class you gonna have to know about for this that it have a smooth circular muscles. Which type of muscles does it contain? It contain a smooth circular muscles. And yes, class, if it contain a smooth circular muscles as well as it possesses which type of skeleton? एक तो मैंने muscles का पहले बता दिया तुम लोगों को. That what type of muscles contain? It contain smooth circular muscles. And if I am talking about skeleton, so what do you think which type of skeleton does it contain? Either it contain exoskeleton, either it contain endoskeleton, or either it contain hydrostatic skeleton. That's very great. That earthworm possesses hydrostatic skeleton. And now what do we mean by the word hydrostatic skeleton? Skeleton. And what do we mean by the word skeleton? अगर मैं word skeleton को focus करता हूँ तो what do you think that what is skeleton meant to be as? Skeleton किसको कहोगे? If I'm talking about skeleton, so what is the best thing you're gonna have to go for skeleton? Shape, support or protection? चलो स्ट्रक्चर भी कर लो. शेप, स्ट्रक्चर, सपोर्ट, प्रोटेक्शन. व्हाट इज द बेस्ट थिंग यू गोना हैव टू चूज फॉर स्केलेटन? सपोर्ट. यस एग्जैक्टली राइट. देखो द बेस्ट थिंग व्हिच यू गोना हैव टू चूज फॉर स्केलेटन दैट इज अ वर्ड व्हिच इज कॉल्ड व्हाट? सपोर्ट. एंड इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट फॉर हाइड्रोस्टेटिक, हाइड्रो मींस व्हाट? हाइड्रो मींस वाटर, स्टैटिक मींस प्रेशर. So support which is being provided by the pressure of water, that support referred to be as hydrostatic skeleton. So earthworm basically it's a terrestrial organism. जिस तरह हम अगर earthworm का अगर scientific name देखें, what is the scientific name of earthworm? Any idea? Abhi, Hasan, Taha, Basit, any idea about for the scientific name of earthworm? Basically the scientific name, bhi aap hum karte hue chalte hain, the scientific name of earthworm referred to be as Lumbricus terrestris. Tum mein se kisi ka mic bahut disturb kar raha hai, kindly switch off your mic and just answer me on chat. Lumbricus terrestris, that is the name of earthworm. Theek hai. So yes, you will find the name of it aur tumhe puri units of classification earthworm ki milegi chapter number 5 mein फर्स्ट ईयर में. ठीक है. सो यू गोना हैव टू गो फॉर डेट एज वेल फॉर योर एमकैट प्रिपरेशन. अपने एमकैट प्रिपरेशन के लिए उसको भी थोड़ा सा गो थ्रू करते हुए चलना. ओके, नाउ कम बैक टू द टॉपिक. वी गोना हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट फॉर लोकोमोशन इन अर्थवॉर्म. एंड यस क्लास, इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट फॉर अर्थवॉर्म, इट आल्सो रेफर्ड टू बी एज लुम्ब्रिकस टेरेस्ट्रिस. अ टाइप ऑफ मसल इट कंटेन, स्मूथ सर्कुलर मसल. एंड अ टाइप ऑफ स्केलेटन डज इट कंटेन? इट कंटेन हाइड्रोस्टैटिक स्केलेटन. Its body would be supported by the pressure of water. And yes, class, it performs movement by means of a smooth circular muscles. Now, what if I am talking about a part, smooth circular muscles? How does it look like? And just if I am asking about a part first class, just tell me that how does muscles perform its working? Muscles working as a perform. Exactly, contraction and relaxation. The muscles perform its working by means of contraction and relaxation. And inside the body of earthworm, what we have? We have the pressure of water. Inside the body of earthworm, what we have? We have the pressure of water. So as the body of earthworm contracted, jaise hi agar earthworm ki body contract kar rahi hai, so the water will be moving forward. Just for example, एक elongated balloon देखते हो, एक जो लंबा वाला balloon होता है, उसको एक तरफ से squeeze करते हो, तो क्या होता है? एक तरफ से हवा थोड़ी सी आगे चली जाएगी, लाजमी सी बात है, एक balloon है, उसको आप एक तरफ से squeeze करोगे, तो उसका जो fluid होगा या जो भी है उसके अंदर air मौजूद है, वो कहाँ move कर जाएगी? It goes on to the forward direction, ठीक है? जहाँ पे squeeze करोगे, जहाँ पे उसको मौका मिलेगा, वो वहाँ पे क्या करेगा? मूवमेंट स्टार्ट करेगा. सो लेट सी इट ओवर हियर. यहाँ पे जरा सा देखते जाओ, यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा फॉर्म करता हुआ चलो. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, दैट्स अ सर्टेन स्ट्रेटेड अर्थवर्म वी हैव. यस, इफ दे आर स्क्वीजिंग, अगर ये अपने आप को यहाँ से स्क्वीज करना स्टार्ट कर रहा है, ठीक है, तो वॉट हैपन ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट. अब नेक्स्ट फेज में क्या होगा? ये पार्ट स्क्वीज होगा, सो द प्रेशर of the fluid goes into the forward direction, isn't it? The pressure, देखो यहाँ से ये part squeeze हुआ, तो इसका जो squeezing element है, जब वो जो भी fluid है, वो कहाँ move करेगा? Onto the forward direction. And as it goes onto the forward direction would be what? ये straight रहेगा या bend कर रहा है? What do you see over here? It would be bended. And as it bend, and when this contraction being relaxed, अब ये contraction अगर relax होती है, तो ये it again come back onto the certain shape. लेकिन इस तरह करने से क्या हो रहा है? It moves forward. ये bending position, just for example, that is the earthworm. It squeezes itself, so by means of that, it would be bent, and after that, it would be relaxed. So in this way, they are gonna perform its movement. So would you think either there is any difficulty into the locomotion of earthworm? So what we have to see that it contains smooth circular muscles, and we know that if it contain muscles, it performing contraction and relaxation. Earthworm containing the skeleton that is called hydrostatic skeleton, and for that class, for in order to perform locomotion, it squeezes itself. ये अपने आप को क्या कर रहा है? Squeeze कर रहा है. तो water pressure आगे की तरफ move कर रहा है. Water pressure आगे की तरफ move कर रहा है. तो ये क्या हो रहा है? बैंड हो रहा है. बैंड होगा फिर रिलैक्स होगा, तो इस तरह क्या होगी? इट परफॉर्मिंग अ सर्टेन मूवमेंट. कोई मसला बॉयज यहाँ पर? ओके, अभी आयो. ओके, सो दैट बीइंग अ वेरी इजी टॉपिक, दैट बीइंग अ वेरी इजी थिंग व्हिच वी गोना हैव टू फॉलो अबाउट फॉर द अर्थवर्म. एंड नाउ वी गोना हैव टू नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म हमारे पास. थोड़ा सा जल्दी करते हुए चलो. अभी लोकोमोशन है, locomotion and snail. So let's getting about a part for locomotion and snail. Locomotion and snail start करना है. तो साथ साथ मुझे बता दे भी जाओ, snail belongs to which phylum? Yes, class. Mollusca. Mollusca are also referred to be as mollusca. क्या कहलाता है? Exactly. Basically, the next thing we're gonna have to follow, that is the locomotion in snail. And if I'm talking about for locomotion in a snail belongs to the phylum that's called mollusca. And to which class of mollusca a snail would be belong? Options दे दे. तो options हमारे पास है, monoplacophora, bivalvia, gastropoda, cephalopoda. Yes, exactly right. A snail belongs to the phylum that is mollusca of its class, which is called gastropoda. Okay? Okay. So, how we can see about to the detail of a snail? A snail belongs to mollusca of its class gastropoda. And now next we're going to have to see about a snail. Either it consists of which type of a skeleton class? Either it contains endoskeleton, exoskeleton, or hydrostatic skeleton. Okay. It contain a snail contain exoskeleton, and the amount of skeleton and the amount of exoskeleton in the snail would be in a certain concentrated form, or it would be present in a certainly a little amount. A बहुत ही little amount में exoskeleton मौजूद होता है या फिर एक बहुत high concentration में मौजूद होता है. Concentrated. Okay. And what we call that exoskeleton? Any idea, boys? Yes, it is called shell, and certainly it is being spiral in shape. So class, that is somewhat about for a snail, and yes, that is somewhat about shell, and the soft body part is called what? The soft body part is called mantle. The hard body part is called shell, and the soft body part is called mantle. Shell is somewhat made up of exoskeleton, isn't it? So I am giving you a topic that what is the exoskeleton would be present in a snail. Either it is being made up of chitin, either it is being made up of calcium carbonate. Okay, so that's great. In a snail, the shell would be, as you have to see that on your book as well, that it is being made up of what is being made up of calcium carbonate. Okay. So, by means of that huge exoskeleton, either it is being easy for the snail to perform its movement. So, how does it perform some movement? Either it perform a very rapid movement or it perform a very slow movement. It perform a very slow movement. Okay. So, let's see it over here. Class, do you have any idea the mouth of the snail referred to be as a what? The mouth part of the snail, exactly right, the mouth part of the snail that happened to be as radula. And remember that this radula produces a slimy secretion. This radula produces a slimy secretion which is called slime, or slimy secretions bhi keh sakte usko. The radula produces the slimy secretions, and that slime do what? What is the role of that slime? That slime would come from the mouth part of the snail, and that slime do what? It come onto the surface and it reduces the friction. What does it do? It reduces the friction between surface and snail. Ye snail aur surface ki friction ko kya karega? Reduce karega. Slimy secretion hoti hai. Ye slimy secretion pe kya hoga? A snail move karega. By way the friction of the snail would be reduces and it moves forward. So I think one of the mic would be very disturbing. थोड़ा सा mic disturb कर रहा है. I just request you to close your mics. और मुझे जब मैं answer कुछ करूँ तो मुझे उसके साथ साथ answer करना है. ठीक है, थोड़ा सा mic किसी का disturb कर रहा है. अच्छा, let's see it on to the part. मैं दोबारा से इसको focus करवाता हूँ. If I'm talking about snail belongs to the phylum Mollusca of its class Gastropoda. Yes, it contains a very high amount of exoskeleton, and that is called shell, and that shell is made up of calcium carbonate. Yes, it have a soft body part that is called mantle, and yes, the mouth part of the snail that's called radula, from which it produces a slime, which is a slimy secretion. That slime would be comes from the mouth of the snail, and it goes onto the surface, and on that surface, when a snail moves, it would reduces the slime reduces the friction for a snail to move forward. In this, they are getting no trouble for the movement. Yet, yes, we know very well the movement of the snail would be quite very slow. So, class, कोई मसला यहाँ तक. अब अपने mic open करके मुझे बता दो अगर कोई मसला हो तो. फिर Okay. So, that is more about the part for snail. I think that's not being a very difficult topic to study. And now the next thing we gonna have to study about the part, or next one's about the part was locomotion and starfish. Okay, starfish belongs to which file? And what do you mean by the word echinoderma? Echinodermata. देखो, echinodermata. You gonna have to drive the word ना. ये देखो, derm. Derm means what? Dermata. Skin. Echino. Echino means spiny. So it meant to be a so what? Spiny skin. And yes, we don't have to study about locomotion in time domain at all. We're gonna have to study locomotion in starfish. And yes, we know very well that this starfish belongs to what? This starfish belongs to echinodermata. Okay, now if I'm talking about for starfish, it has the two sides. And having the two sides, one is rough, one is a little bit rough, and one is being smooth. One is rough and one's being smooth. So the thing which is being rough, the thing which is being smooth, so remember that the thing which is being smooth, it possesses eyes and mouth. It possesses eyes and mouth. And yes, the thing which is being rough, it possesses the tube feet. What does it possess, guys? It possesses the tube feet. Now what is that tube feet? Tube feet is responsible for what? Just for example, just first you are going to have to tell me that a starfish would be sessile or motile. How you can say it would be motile? As we can see onto the aquarium that it would be stick or with its substratum. So how you can say it would be motile? As water pressure, kab move kar diya abhi? अच्छा देखो देखो एग्जैक्टली स्टारफिश रिमेन अटैचेस विद सबस्ट्रेटम. अब वो कोई भी रॉक हो या कोई भी सॉलिड पार्ट हो, स्टारफिश उस पार्ट से अटैच है कि जब तक उसको वहाँ पे फूड मिल रहा है. जब उसको फूड वहाँ से नहीं मिलेगा, इट डिटैच इटसेल्फ एंड मूव्स ऑन टू द सर्टेन डिफरेंट पार्ट वेयर दे गेट द फूड. सो दैट इज अ थिंग विच यू गॉट टू रिमेंबर. इट वुड बी मोस्टली सेसाइल, एज इट वुड बी मोस्टली सेसाइल ऑन दोस सबस्ट्रेटम वेयर इट गेट द फूड. But as it does not get the food, it moves from there and just go on to the place where does it where it get the food. So, how does it remain attached to the substratum? अब ये अपने substratum, substratum कोई भी rock हो सकता है, कोई भी solid part हो सकता है. तो ये अपने substratum से कैसे attached होते हैं? It remain attached to its substratum by means of about a part that's called tube feet. And yes, you gonna have to know about for tube feet. That a tube feet consists of two things. One is sucker and one is ampulla. It having the two things, one is sucker and another one is ampulla. So one thing you're gonna have to remember about a part that starfish performing water, starfish would remain attached to its substratum by means of water vascular pressure. Okay? On the top of it have ampulla. On top of it have ampulla, and on to the bottom of it having sucker. मतलब टॉप पे क्या चीज आ रही है ट्यूब फीट के? देखो ट्यूब फीट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ टू पार्ट, वन इज एम्प्यूला एंड अनदर वन इज सकर. कोई मसला आया था? अच्छा मुझे बता दे जाओ, वेयर डज द ट्यूब फीट वुड बी प्रेजेंट? आइदर इट इज बीइंग प्रेजेंट ऑन द साइड ऑफ इट्स आइज एंड माउथ, और आइदर इट इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द डिफरेंट साइड. साथ साथ बता दे जाओ, ऑन द अदर साइड. And that other side would be the part which is being attaches with the substratum. ये other side वो part है जहाँ से ये substratum पे attach होगा. And how does it attaches to the substratum? By means of a bottom part that is called tube feet. And that tube feet consisting of the two things. One on the top we have the ampulla and on the bottom we have a sucker. So how does it generate? So class, you can see it over here. The water pressure would be goes on to the sucker and it goes on to the ampulla. मतलब ये water pressure जा रहा है ampulla तक. जब तक water vascular pressure रहेगा, the starfish remain attached. जब तक water vascular pressure रहेगा, जब तक pressure अंदर जा रहा है वो tube feed के, तो starfish remain attached to the body. And as the water pressure releases, जैसे ही water pressure release होगा, the starfish become detached. मतलब the tube feed would be detached, the starfish would be detached. So you're gonna have to remember the things which is being responsible for the locomotion or for the attachment or detachment. That is somewhat about a part that is tube feet. And where does the tube feet would be present? It is present on the rough side, and they are being so many in number. They are being so many in number. Spiny scales ki tarah mein dikhte hain, as you can see onto the ऑन योर लैब स्पेसिमेन एज वेल। लैब स्पेसिमेंस में मैं दिखाऊंगा तुम लोगों को जैसे मौका मिलता है मुझे। तो ग्राफाइट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ ट्यू फीड एंड कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ द टू साइड, वन इज एम्प्यूला एंड द सकर, एम्प्यूला ऑन टॉप एंड ऑन द बॉटम वी हैव द सकर। एज अ वाटर वेस्कुलर प्रेशर गोस इनसाइड द ट्यू फीड द स्टारफिश रिमेन अटैच। जैसे ही वाटर वेस्कुलर प्रेशर अंदर जाता जाएगा स्टारफिश रिमेन अटैच टू द सबस्ट्रेटम। लेकिन अगर स्टारफिश ये समझता है कि वहां पे अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ फूड खत्म हो रहा है तो इट रिलीजेस द वाटर वेस्कुलर प्रेशर एंड इट बिकम डिटैच, एंड व्हेन इट बिकम डिटैच इट मूव्स बाय द प्रेशर ऑफ वाटर टुवर्ड्स दोज एरिया वेयर इट गेट इट्स फूड। कोई मसला बॉयज इसके चलो सो चलो एंड अ वेरी नेक्स्ट थिंग वी हैव वेरी नेक्स्ट थिंग वी हैव लोकोमोशन एंड कॉकरोच। ओके so cockroach belongs to phylum what is arthropoda, and what is arthropoda meant to be as jointed legs jointed feet, how many classes we have in arthropoda, kitni thi, five thi. So let's talk about a part that is locomotion in cockroach. Now if I am talking about for locomotion in cockroach, so class, cockroach belongs to, as you say, that it belongs to the phylum Arthropoda, the largest phylum of kingdom Animalia, and yes, that Arthropoda, from that Arthropoda, it belongs to class, exactly right, it belongs to class Insecta, the largest class. The Arthropoda consisting of about approximately 1 million species out of 1.3 million. And Insecta out of 1 million, it consisting of about consisting of about 850,000 as compared to 10 lakh. 10 lakh or 1 million species we have in Arthropoda, and out of that 10 lakh species, 850,000 species would be present in Insecta. मतलब 5 classes है हमारे पास Arthropoda की, which comprises of whole about 1 million species or 10 lakh. And out of that, Insecta only consisting of about 850,000 species. So that is the thing which you're going to have to remember. And very next thing which I'm going to have to elaborate over here, we're going to have to discuss about the locomotion in cockroach. So for locomotion in cockroach, I'm going to have to say that cockroach having a very fine muscles in their appendages, and that muscles is flexor and extensor. That is the antagonist muscles we have in cockroach, and that is called flexor and extensor. Have you studied flexor and extensor? Okay, we have done that part on our previous lecture. So antagonist muscle, just for example, it is being present on our bicep, tricep. मतलब हम जब अपना bicep contract करते हैं, हमारा tricep relax होता है. हम अपना tricep relax करते हैं, tricep contract करते हैं, तो हमारा bicep relax हो जाता है. Similarly, simultaneously, that certain type of the antagonist muscles we have found on the appendages of cockroach. But just tell me what, how many appendages we have in cockroach? Okay, so we have approximately 6 appendages, and let's see it over here. The one appendages which is being, the one appendages, and so let's see it over here. यहाँ पे दो conditions हैं. So which one would be contracted, which one would be relaxed? As we can see, this condition. I'm just holding for Adan. Adan mujhe phir isko start karte hain. Okay. So let's back on to the topic. We have the flexor and extensor type of muscles in cockroach. So as you can see, this thing, it would be a certain contracted condition. ये कौन सी condition हमें show हो रही है? Contraction. Okay. And this condition would be certainly relaxation, isn't it boys? दिख रहा है ये तुम लोगों को? Contraction, relaxation. It would be contracted, it would be relaxed. So as you can see over here, that this part would be certainly show the contraction, which we goes for flexor, and that is a certain thing which is being relaxation, which we goes for extensor. So this flexor and extensor type of a condition makes cockroach to move really very slow or really very fast. very fast. Yes, the flexor and extensor performs a very rapid action. Just for example, this thing would be present in our arms, this thing would be present in our legs as well. And if it would be present in our legs, we also move very fast by means of our leg, by means of that type of muscles. So yes, that's a certain type of muscles we have in cockroach as well. The flexor and extensor, the antagonist muscles, and in this way they are performing contraction and relaxation, and by means of that it moves very, very fast. So that is about for locomotion in cockroach. And now next, what we have, the last thing we have about apart, that is locomotion and vertebrates. Okay. Next, back on to the topic, that is we're gonna have to study about a very short topic to study, that is locomotion and vertebrates. We all know about a part, what are vertebrates? Vertebrates which have vertebrae. In fact, the notochord develops into the vertebral cosmos. So tum log agar tumse koi vertebrates, dekho main chordates nahi pooch raha, agar tumse koi chordates poochta hai, माइक बंद करो भाई अपने करने। अच्छा, अगर तुम लोग से कोई कॉर्डेट्स पूछता है तो रिमेंबर दैट यू गोना हैव टू आंसर अबाउट फॉर दैट कॉर्डेट्स आर दोस व्हिच हैव डॉर्सल नोटोकॉर्ड, डॉर्सल नर्व ट्यूब एंड फैरिंजियल गैस्ट्रेट्स। ठीक है, अभी मैं तुमसे कॉर्डेट्स नहीं, मैं तुमसे वर्टीब्रेट्स पूछता हूं। तो अगर मैं तुमसे वर्टीब्रेट्स पूछूं तो यू गोना हैव टू आंसर मी इन अ वे इन विच द नोटोकॉर्ड डेवलप्स इनटू वर्टीब्रल कॉलम। कि जिसमें अगर नोटोकॉर्ड वर्टीब्रल कॉलम में डेवलप हो, दैट इज अबाउट फॉर वर्टीब्रेट्स। एंड can you tell me how many things, how many parts or how many classification into vertebrates are divided? And that is what? Are you gone, Siddhi? Aja, there are two things. One is agnatha and another one is gnathostomata. Agnatha, the mouth without jaws. ठीक है, और गिनेथोस्टोमेटा माउथ विद जॉस। वर्टिब्रेट्स की अगर मैं बात करूं, क्रेनिएट्स, वर्टिब्रेट्स क्रेनिएट्स को ही कहते हो ना, इन विच द वर्टिब्रल कॉलम वुड बी डेवलप फ्रॉम द नोटोकॉर्ड, कि जिसमें नोटोकॉर्ड वर्टिब्रल कॉलम को डेवलप करे, दैट इज क्रेनिएट्स, दैट इज द वर्टिब्रेट्स, विच वुड बी फर्दर डिवाइडेड इनटू द टू पार्ट, एग्नेथा एंड गिनेथोस्टोमेटा। एग्नेथा जिसमें हमने लैम्प्रे प्लेस किया था, और गिनेथोस्टोमेटा इन विच वी प्लेस द टू सुपर क्लासेस, वन इज सुपर क्लास स्पाइसेस and another one would be superclass. Pehli to superclass spices thi, dusri superclass kaun si thi? Aha, acha, just make the word, these are the superclass having four legs. Ab mujhe batao kya naam tha sahi se. Aha, nahi ए भाई, वो तो उन सब क्लास, देखो दे आर कॉल्ड टेट्रापोड, एम्फीबियन रेप्टाइल्स, एप्स, दे ऑल आर कम्स इनटू द क्लास दैट इज कॉल्ड टेट्रापोड हैविंग फोर लेग्स। सो वी हैव द टू सुपर क्लासेस इन गिनेथोस्टोमेटा, वन इज सुपर क्लास स्पाइसेस एंड अनदर वन सुपर क्लास टेट्रापोडा, इन विच वी हैव एम्फीबियंस, रेप्टाइल्स, एप्स एंड द लास्ट वन दैट इज नाउ। सो वी गोना हैव टू मेक आवर टॉपिक locomotion and vertebrates. So if I'm talking about for the very first thing about for pisces, we know very well pisces are amphibious. For what? What are pisces? They are fishes. Okay, how does they locomote? By their fins. Okay, the locomotion in pisces done by means of their fins. And what are fins? Either they would be the pectorals or either they would be the pelvic. फिन्स को किस में प्लेस करो? मैं पेक्टोरल्स है, पेक्टोरल और पेल्विक क्या होता है? हाँ, पेक्टोरल और पेल्विक क्या होता है? पेल्विक जो नीचे का हाइंड लिम होता है, हाइंड लिम्स है, सही है ना? और पेक्टोरल्स क्या होते हैं? ऊपर वाले फोर लिम्स। तो फिन्स क्या है? पेक्टोरल्स है, ठीक है। और टेल, देखो फिशेस लोकोमोट, फिशेस लोकोमोट बाय मीन्स ऑफ देयर फिन्स, but fishes can change their direction by means of their tail. अपना जो direction है fishes, वो कैसे change करता है? By means of their tail, ठीक है। तो टेल इज यूज फॉर चेंजिंग द डायरेक्शन. यस, टेल वुड बी द पेल्विक एंड फिन्स वुड बी द पेक्टोरल. ये चीज याद रखना, ठीक है. एंड नाउ नेक्स्ट वर्ड बी एफ, विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी फर्दर टाइम वी गोना हैव टू गो फॉर एम्फीबियंस. And yes, last, what is the movement of Pisces referred to be as? Pisces की movement या fishes की movement को क्या कहते हैं? In performing swimming by means of their fins. Okay. Now, very next thing we have about a part that is amphibians. Amphibians in which we place what? क्या place करते हैं हम लोग? Generally बोलते जो boys, frog, toad and exactly frog, toad and salamander. And how does it perform its movement? Exactly, but if I'm talking about frog and toad, they are just performing its movement. They are just performing its movement in a certain jumping manner, in which they mostly utilize their hind limbs. मतलब अपना pectoral, अपना pelvic ये ज़्यादा utilize करते हैं, ठीक है? But if I'm talking about for salamander, it is a lizard-like amphibian. So it all performing crawling. ये salamander crawl करेगा, lizard-like amphibian है. ये crawl करेगा, लेकिन अगर मैं amphibians में frog और toad को include करता हूँ, so they are performing jumping by means of their hind limb. So that is the thing which you gonna have to remember about for Pisces and amphibians. And if I am talking about to the very next thing, that is about for reptiles. Okay, so how does reptiles perform its movement? What is the thing we have in reptile to perform the movement? Yes, the movement of reptile is called crawling, but how does they perform crawling? By the claws. Yes, exactly right. Reptiles performing crawling by means of their claws. And what is the one of the clawless reptile that is called what? A snake. And how does the snake perform its movement? By means of their abdominal muscles. By means of their abdominal muscles. Okay? So that is what about for reptiles. And now next what we have about for apes. Apes are referred to be as what? You know very well that it is birds. And how does it perform its movement? By means of their pectorals. Pectorals can fore limbs, and their fore limbs are modified into wings. And in this way they are performing flying, isn't it? And a very last which we're going to have to focus over here, that is about for mammals. That is mammals. And how does mammals perform its movement? Yes, class. How does mammals perform movement? Yes, exactly. They are performing by means of their feet. Some of the mammals utilizes both fold. They require both limbs to perform the movement. Means they require fore limbs as well as hind limbs. Just for example, cat, dog, cow, goat. They all utilize their fore limbs and hind limbs for performing movement. Whereas if I'm talking about for human, they are performing movement by means of their hind limbs. Kangaroo, they are also performing movement by means of their hind limbs. And if I'm talking about whale perform the locomotion exactly like the Pisces, and bat performing locomotion exactly like the birds. So that is somewhat all about we have to the part regarding locomotion and animals. So koi masla aaj ke topic ke liye, boys.